you guys didn't just stop with the Comics Journal. You did actually build out a pretty important library of content.
We have, almost by accident, though. We started essentially by publishing Love and Rockets by Gilbert and Jaime Hernandez. And that was almost accidentally. Sent me a copy of their own self-published Love and Rockets. And I was so taken by it that I wrote a review in the Comics Journal. I mean, I was just really excited to see this. It was something so fresh and so new. And I recognized that their priorities as artists were radically different from virtually everything else that was being done at the time. And then I think I probably just casually asked them if they'd be interested in having us publish it, because we had this kind of inchoate infrastructure where we sold the Comics Journal through comic book stores and by subscription. And so we had this set up so we could essentially publish anything and push it through this this distribution system that was still being formed at the time. And then they foolishly said, yes, we'd love to have you publish us. And we started publishing them in 82 as a result. And then after that, we suddenly found ourselves publishing, you know, the work of other cartoonists. So then Peter Bagg started in 1984. Dan Clowes started in 1985. I think Jim Woodring started in 1986. And artists just started submitting work to us, and we became more and more aware of what artists were out there, and we just started publishing comics.
I mean, those guys that you just talked about, I mean, their body of work, it's really diverse. It's not like I look at Jim Woodring and I look at Dan Clowes and be like, oh my God. I mean, there are elements there that are, I mean, were you guys going out there and trying to have like, what was it about all of these titles that you were like, the people need to read this?
Well, I think, if you look at the underground cartoonists, the best underground cartoonists, they were all unique. No underground cartoonist drew like any other. So you had, 10, 15, 20 guys who were all really first-rate cartoonists, all drawing entirely differently, all with an entirely different vision of the world. I mean, Spain was nothing like Crumb, who was nothing like Bill Griffith, who was nothing like Art Spiegelman, who was nothing like S. Clay Wilson, and so on. And so what I saw coming up in the 80s was the same dynamic. You had artists with unique visions who were nothing like each other in terms of style and approach and the way they saw the world, but what their common denominator was, they did have this unique vision. They had everything. They had not only the vision, but they had the craft to convey that vision. They had the discipline, they had the passion, they had the commitment, and they had some sort of inner barometer of quality, inner barometer of standards, where they appreciated each other, and they appreciated, and they saw this distinctive vision in each other, and I think that's what kind of pulled us all together.
Thanks for watching. Click here to subscribe.